Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. First of all, I would like to congratulate the higher management for organizing such a marvelous international camel conference in the Peer Mir Ali Shah Arid Agriculture University, Rawalpindi. So definitely it is an opportunity for me to present my results, my experience over here in a virtual conference. And tomorrow I will be there to join you. The topic which I will discuss, that is impact of various watering regimes on milk production, physiological and hematological parameters in Maricha she camel reared in extensive summer conditions. This is research which has been done at Desert Thal Rakhmani Camel Breeding and Research Station under the supervision of Professor Dr. Muhammad Yunus with Naimullah Khan and myself. So I'm going to present this topic. Kindly, next slide, please.
Okay.
Regarding my introduction, I feel that the ma'am has delivered a brief introduction of mine. I'm Dr. Asim, Assistant Professor, Bahauddin Zakaria University, Pakistan. And I am Secretary General Camel Association of Pakistan, which is dealing with the research and other kind of activities regarding camel. And I'm also serving as General Secretary Pakistan Camel Club. I'm serving as focal person, International Camel Organization, and executive member and public relation officer of International Camel Research and Development Society, ISOCARD. Next slide, please, ma'am. Here, this is first one. Yes, thank you. So let's start with the topic. Livestock contributes 61% in the agriculture and 11% in the GDP in Pakistan, and definitely it is an integral part. The camel is playing its role in the socioeconomic uplift and in the pastoral systems. Well, when we talk about the camel population, there are 35 million heads in the world, and Pakistan ranks 8th in the world with 1.1 million camel population. When we talk about the dromedaries population, it is 94%, and 70% of these are present in India and Pakistan, while Maricha is the most productive breed in Pakistan. Next, please. The camel is well adapted and tolerant, having unique physiology and adaptation. It has a special ability by God that it can fluctuate its body temperature between 34 and 41 degrees Celsius around the clock. The camels can survive with 30% dehydration, and it can consume up to 100 liters in a limited time of water. So it has advanced water balance system. It can produce milk even in the harsh deserts with the lack of food and water. Next, please. Faced to water shortage, camel has the special ability to maintain their metabolism while feed digestibility is not affected in this situation in this species. It has specialized metabolic and physiologic adaptation, which allows it to survive in the water deprivation periods without any perishing. For water scarcity during dry season and droughts, it can tolerate very well. And this study was conducted in Camel Breeding and Research Station regarding the milk production performance, physiological and hematological parameters in response to water deprivation to check the stability and the efficacy of the camel to produce in the severe desert conditions under summer environment. Next, please. Regarding the methodology, there were 12 early lactating Maricha camels, which were divided into three groups and fed with Lucerne and Gram straw residues. The trial was of 60 days with 7 days as adaptation period. The three groups, the G1 was considered as control, which were allowed, the animals were allowed daily 30 minutes water access, Then G2, group 2 allowed once after 4 days for 30-minute access, while in group 3, after 6 days, 30-minute access. While the health status was monitored, they were dewormed with ivermectin injection for endoparasites and Ecoflea spray for ectoparasites, while they were vaccinated with trypanosome injection for the trypanosomiasis. So the animals were trypanosome free. Next, please. The morning milking was done daily by hand technique at 7, while respiration rate, pulse rate, rectal temperature were recorded after milking. The calf were allowed suckling for 1 minute, and then lactating she camels were wearing udder net to prevent the calf suckling. Feeding was offered at 10 a.m. and then watering to control group G1 was done on daily basis, while G2 and G3, according to their protocols, as after 4 days in G2 and after 6 days in G3 for 30 minutes water access. The evening hand milking was performed at 4 to 5 p.m. and then animals were allowed free set to move in the paddock and then were housed in respective separate pens. Next, please. At end of the water deprivation period, the milk samples were collected and transformed to the milk laboratory of Camel Breeding Research Station, Rakhmani, for further analysis. While the dry matter intake was calculated on daily basis, the blood samples, 5 ml, were collected by jugular puncture. EDTA was used as anticoagulant, while the samples from G1 were collected once a week, G2 on day 4 before watering, and in group 3 on day 6 before watering, then analyzed for CBC by using hematology analyzer by the provided company Mindre, Germany. The room temperature and humidity average was found 39 to 41 degrees Celsius and 55 to 63%, while the respiratory rate was monitored by flank movements, pulse rate from coccygeal artery, while body weight changes before watering by impressing weighing scale by Pakistan. The data collected was analyzed statistically under completely randomized design. Next, please. When we talk about the results, watering regimes, it is interesting to see that watering regimes affected water intake significantly. Here you can see the water intake, that is 18.3 liters in group 1, 47.7 liters in group 2, and 82.8 liters in group 3. We can observe that when we deprive the camel by water, it can recompensate its allowance within 30 minutes time, which was offered, and it can increase its intake, and you can see the higher intake in the group 3. While the water contents from feed from Lucerne was measured, that was also higher as 12.4 liters in group 3. When we talk about the intake of fodder, and we can see that in group 3, the animals consume highest rate of fodder, and watering regimes affected dry matter intake. Maximum dry matter intake was found in G1 as there was water access daily, and then in G2, and lowest was observed in the group 3. While daily dry matter intake was lower when camels were deprived of water for 6 days. No doubt the camel can recompensate its dehydration loss, but the daily dry matter intake was decreased. Next, please. Next, please. Thank you. Watering regimes have non-significant effect on dry matter water intake ratio. While the maximum dry matter water intake ratio was found in group 3, followed by group 2 and group 1. When we talk about the milk production, it was decreased as the water deprivation was prolonged, and the decrease was significant. While milk production of group 1, group 2 and group 3 was observed as 4.5, 4 and 3.8 liters, no doubt there is a significant decrease, but you can see the camels are able to produce 3.8 liters in the group 3 where they were faced water deprivation for 6 days. Watering regimes affect significantly the milk fat percentage. which was increased in group 2 and group 3 than in group 1. While mean values for fat were G1, G2 and G3, you can see here, an increased level was reported in camels facing deprivation of 6 days. Next, please. No, last slide. Yes. Watering regimes affected significantly the milk protein percentages, which was being higher in animals facing deprivation, water deprivation for 6 days, while watering regimes affected lactose percentage non-significantly. They affected milk total solids percentage significantly, while watering regimes have a significant effect on milk density, while body weight affected significantly by water deprivation periods. Here you can see the body loss, 32 and 45 kg weight loss in animals deprived of water for 4 and 6 consecutive days. So it is clear from the fact that the animals consume their body fat, body reserves to compensate its body maintenance, and they have maintained their milk production even in the deprivation period. Next, please. Here you can see the results regarding the temperature, respiration rate, and pulse rate. There is a non-significant effect and in rectal temperature, respiration rate, and pulse rate. So there is not a significant effect on the water deprivation on the camels. Next, please. When you talk about the hematology, only the packed cell volume, hemoglobin, and WBCs were affected significantly, while in RBCs, MCH, MCHC, and mean corpuscular volume was non-significantly affected by the watering regimes treatment. Next, please. Water restriction decreased feed intake as reported by the Jolly and Varda. While feed intake has not been decreased in current study, it is probably due to the availability of the lush green fodder. While the camels of G3 drank 6 times more than G1 and compensated body loss after rehydration in just few minutes, as we offered just 30 minutes water provision. So camel can consume the water once enough to compensate water losses during dehydration, as reported by the scientist Seibert. And we have read from the literature data that even in a mere time, camel can consume up to 100 liters of water and can recompensate its body loss. While camel can survive without water up to weeks in hot deserts, but feed intake was observed to be decreased. While the camel decreases feed intake and metabolic rate during the dehydration period, as reported by the Bekele et al. 2011. Next, please. Dry matter intake and water intake have positive correlation. While dry matter intake decreases with the prolonged water deprivation to 4 days in Indian camels under desert condition, and these results are almost same with our study. While the dry matter intake was decreased 9.6% when camels faced water deprivation for 11 days. Water is the most important nutrient for lactation. Milk production decreases 16% during water restriction, even in the dairy cat. Camel produced the same milk water contents during water deprivation and drought condition. It has the special ability that camel has acted signal restriction while fat TS 1400 its milk. It has the next, please. Yes. Camel does not dilute its milk during the dehydration phase due to change in the milk and plasma. Osmolality during drinking water did not. Milk production and lactose contents were found better in dehydrated camels. While camels recompensate their body mass loss by consuming huge amount of water at the time of rehydration after water deprivation phase. Next, please. Desert mammals could regulate their body temperature over a much wider range, daily by some 6 degrees centigrade or 7 degrees centigrade. And camel has the ability to fluctuate its body temperature 34 degrees Celsius to 41. And here that it has the special ability, special potential by the God that it can reduce sweating when there is a chances of in the drought condition to recompensate the body water losses. While body temperature and respiratory rate decreased with increasing starvation, indicating a reduced metabolism. Next, please. When we talk about the packed cell volume, that was increased in camels during water deprivation for 6 days. The results were same as reported by the Seabird. And I'm just reading the messages from the chat. And one scientist from the Kenya here in our group has reported that he has also got the same results. A significant increase in the packed cell volume of blood was found when camels were water deprived for 4 days, as reported by Al-Haj and Al-Hadri at the same study results. While there was a significant increase in the leukocyte count of dehydrated camels, while the water deprivation significantly impacted the WBCs in the reported results. Next, please. In nutshell, camel can be a productive animal even when subjected to water deprivation for 6 days in deserts. And now we are planning a further study in which we will restrict the water to the camels almost 10 to 12 days. While feed intake and milk production was decreases, while no serious changes was observed in physiological parameters and complete blood count, while the watering after 4 days in group three is the most suitable watering regimes when we talk about the results. The under arid environmental conditions, the camel is the most suitable livestock species capable to provide food security to the pastoralists. Next, please. We were able to publish our data, luckily, in two sections. This data was published in the Animals Journal regarding, you can see the effect of different watering regimes on milk production. And next, please. And the other section was published in Open Veterinary Journal, same in 2021. Next, please. These are the references cited. Next. Yes. Thank you for your patience. It is the end of the talk. Now the topic is open for discussion. Any suggestion and comments, please. I'm again here saying sorry for disturbance. Actually, I have got some problem in my network connection, so it's really embarrassing for me. However, the management was able to control that. So nice of you. Thank you. And congratulations again for organizing such a marvelous opportunity regarding a unique species camel. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Asim Faraz, for your valuable talk and very important, precious research on the watering regimes in camel. There are some questions from our audience. If you want to address kindly.
Yes, please.
This study period was basically conducted in summer or winter. What was the period of the study or months conducted?
That was summer.
What was the duration of this trial?
The study was conducted in June, July months, and these are the hottest months in the Thal Desert. And you can see the temperature and humidity range. It was the hottest months. You can say June, July. And we have started at the end of the May. The trial actually was started in June, and it was lasted to July. We have provided for 7 days as adaptation acclimatization period, and the actual trial was of 60 days.
Okay. Another question is from Mohammed Ijaz. Did you study the changes, any changes in the urine during this study of the animals?
We have planned a further study, and inshallah we will do that study in our further results. We will study, we have included the urine and we have included the feces and the water contents. We are planning to study the water contents, even they shed into the feces. Inshallah, we will do that in 2022, inshallah.
Okay.
One thing I want to add for Mr. Jaz and other audience. Actually, we have 71 camel strength. Total, when you talk about all herd, then it is more than 100. But it is very difficult to find the same parity and same lactation length camels. And luckily, we were able to found 12 camels. When you talk about the camel population, you know, it is fewer in the world. So it is very tough to find more than 5 or 6 camels at a station for the study. Actually, the camels are located in the pastoral systems. And there is a lot of difficulty to study the camels in pastoral system regarding the scientific experiments. And we are planning this research in 2020-21, but unfortunately, we could not find the actual number. So we are waiting for that. Hopefully, inshallah, in 2022, we were able to get, I think, 14 camels. Then we will plan our study.
Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Asim.